check us out on Patreon, guys, where we're giving you the entire year now for $10.08. Over 100 videos worth of content for $10.08.
8 cents is just such a slap in the face.
Like 84 cents a month, I think is what it comes out to.
I haven't seen 84 cents in 15 years. I'm telling you. Ever since Penny Candy.
So check us out on Patreon, guys. Hope to see you there.
The entire year.
What's up, patrons? Your boys are back. I'm Ryan, my man, George.
Boy, shaking, guys. How y'all living out there, man? Shout out to the free thinkers, man.
It's been a little while, huh? It's been a little while, man. So we're trying to be creative, man. And maybe do another marathon. You know, you want to drop that bomb now? Maybe.
There's a couple that we have. Yeah, you guys know, I've been wanting to do the Hated Bands marathon for so long. I just think we would have so much fun.
I think that would be fun.
We're just going back. And really just being as open, and that would really test our objectivity. Like, I really feel like it would be fun to just see kind of what songs we really gravitated to that everyone hated, and do we still feel the same about those songs that we hated or that everyone hates, or did we hate them?
And do you still hate them now?
Do you still hate them
or
now?
Do you have another appreciation for them, a new level of appreciation
right,
for them?
Right, you know? So going through that process, I think would just be fun, and I think it would be a pretty big engagement on your part, even for people who hate those bands.
Right.
Or we've been meaning to get to...
Women of Rock.
Women Who Rock.
Yeah, man.
You know what I'm saying? And doing a marathon that just kind of... just exposes women in rock who have done great things. You know, yep. I think our channel, to be honest, it's just male dominated. You know how it is, man. You know how it is.
But we just want to show females.
There's a trend. We want an excuse to kind of just to hone in on and give a spotlight to female musicians that have done great things, man.
You know what I'm saying? So I think this is the perfect time, man. So we did Crazy on You by heart. Now we're going to do Barracuda. Yeah, that was
dope. Dude, that's like...
That was dope.
That
I like that a lot.
That's one of my favorite songs, man. Not no bullshitting around. Like that riff.
No. That shit was hot.
Yeah,
that was
she crushed
hot.
That.
Yeah, that was hot.
And shout out to I think it was Nancy that hit us up on Twitter and said she really liked the video. Nancy Wilson from Heart. So
yeah, dude.
Shout out to them, man. But this could be the start of a marathon. Not sure, maybe, because we haven't done a marathon in a while. We've just been hitting you guys with a lot of crazy random selections for no rhyme or reason, just trying to get to different bands and different things. So maybe it's time to delve into a marathon, and I think this would be a good one to start.
So let us know. Comment. Let us know what you guys think about that, or if you got some other ideas for other marathons, we're open to that as well. But as a recap, the two that we're thinking about is Hated Bands Marathon or like Women Who Rock Marathon, you know, Women of Rock or however you want to pronounce it. So let us know. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So.
And we're open. All right, man, let's get to it, though. So we're going to do Barracuda, because this was a huge, huge request from this band. I think when we did Crazy On You, Barracuda came up. It came up a lot. I don't know. We haven't counted, you know, the requests, but this was a huge, huge request. And I know this is a big song. Based off the views we're seeing, this is a big song for them as well. So let's see what's going on, man. Heart, Barracuda. A little bit.
Like Green Acres or something? Is that Green Acres?
I don't know.
Is that Green Acres?
That's from Sons. Not Little House on the Prairie. Or is it like, what's that Raw High? Raw High.
Let me just.
It's something about those riffs that just reminds me of an old.
That's not it. That's not what you're talking about.
No, this is like from was it an old Western that I'm thinking of?
Rawhide or something?
Is it raw?
I don't know. We're going to find out because it sounds Bonanza. It's Bonanza, right?
That's amazing if that's it.
I think
I don't even remember Bonanza. That's definitely.
I think that's what it is. Let me see. I think that's what it is.
Well, clearly, I guess I kind of remember it.
Yep, that's it.
So it sounds nothing like that.
No, it's close. That you're talking about that galloping.
The galloping. Yeah.
That's what it is.
The tone of it sounds nothing alike, but it does remind me of Bonanza. Good man.
There you go. Hey,
what?
Hey, you jogged my memory. We weren't going to get any sleep tonight unless we figured that out. So I had to figure that out.
Dude, that was impressive. That was very impressive. Yeah, but the dun da 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 reminds me of Bonanza. Shout out to the Bonanza theme song.
Yeah, I miss theme songs though, man.
Yeah, that was
I really do.
Theme songs and jingles.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Man, them dumbass jingles, man, get you to purchase all kinds of shit. Like, you know, like the
I like a rock, man. That's not really a jingle.
Yeah, but
it's a song.
Oh, like
yeah, dude. Yeah. But you always remember those, man. Mm-hmm. I'm never gonna forget Like a Rock and know that that's associated with what? Four. Or Chevy.
Chevy. That's Chevy. Chevy. Yeah, you about Chevy. To fuck it up.
You know what I'm saying? But it's a truck somewhere in there. Like, you know?
Yeah, yeah. Absolutely.
Anyways, man.
But we digress.
Let's, we'll get back, let's get back to it. Yeah. Sounds kind of dirty, though.
Yeah.
These riffs. Because we, I don't know if you guys heard us, and you probably saw by our mannerisms or whatever that we, we've heard this.
Right, right.
And Ryan made a joke about it being Old Navy. It's always Old Navy.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Old Navy. But I've heard it somewhere. But the thing about when I like, when I've heard songs, I just feel like it's, they're at an advantage for me to like it because it's just the nostalgia.
Right.
Associated with it. So I'm like, do I like it because of the nostalgia? And me somewhat hearing it in just in different aspects, or is it because I just think it's, I really do believe that this is hard though.
Yeah, I like it.
I like those riffs.
I like those galloping riffs. I really do. But I like the drumming too.
The drumming is nice.
The drumming, it's basic. It sounds basic, but dude, I like it though. I mean, I think it's, and I like her voice. I don't really, if I'm being 100%, I think her voice, the way she's singing it, it sounds like a Disney movie to me.
It sounds, I like it though.
What's the shit called from Aladdin?
Frozen? Oh, no, Aladdin.
No, when they were...
A Whole New World?
Yeah, you know, when they were riding the fucking magic carpet and shit, you know what I'm saying? That's what it sounds like to me. It sounds like her voice would go perfect with a Disney movie.
But I think that's what makes it kind of...
But I will say she sounds great.
She does sound great.
She sounds great. But I just think it's a stark contrast to what's going on with the riffs, and the galloping riffs,
yes.
Riffs, which is what you like.
I like the fact that she, because like. I would have, if I lined up a whole bunch of people in a room and just played this groove, the band was playing, I don't think a lot of people would have came at this groove, these dirty riffs like that. You know what I'm saying? Even if her voice, her tone is naturally just higher pitched, and she just has this sort of, I don't want to call it Disney-esque tone, but she sounds good, so I'm not trying to clown her.
I'm not clowning
she
it either.
Have, like, the
dude,
rough,
there's some
she
really good singers from Disney.
Yeah.
So don't. I'm not clowning that.
No, I'm not saying you're clowning
I know you're not saying
it,
but I want to make it clear. I ain't clowning it. Continue.
But, you know, she doesn't have a rugged, because, you know, the female singers, they can have rugged tones. It's what Stevie Nicks, I think, has a ruggedness to her tone. I don't think she has that. It's more clean. But I think that, yo, a lot of people would have approached this groove differently. So I think it's just, it's fighting, I think, the groove a little bit. But I think it just works for me.
Yeah.
I think it's cool. It's like these clean, nice, you know, happy vocals with these dirty, nasty, these riffs underneath it.
And
like,
dude, you know, to your point, George, it seems like a lot of people have done covers to this. Like 11 different covers. Yeah, and I didn't know that. So
as you were saying it, I saw a long
time. Yeah, it's crazy. Fergie. You know what I'm saying? That's the only person I can recognize from the list, guys. The Bad Plus, I don't know who that is. So, I mean, a lot of people have covered this, so I'm interested to know if they did it justice or if they kind of approached it a totally different way. But I'm sure they probably just fucking carbon copied the shit like everybody else does.
Maybe, man, but Heart has the sauce, man.
Yeah.
I could just hear it.
Yeah.
I could just hear they just know how to put the shit together, man. You can just hear it.
And even from Crazy on You to this,
Hard.
Dude, that... I think I may really like them as a band. Seriously. You know?
They're rocking. Let's get back to it though.
You have been
Yeah, that's wrong with the
killing this one. Everything. The drums, like Ryan was pointing out. The riffs are nasty. I love the way she's singing this, man. She's rocking it.
But yeah, she's killing it, dude.
The music to let her just get her shit. Like, man, listen. Play you know, this already.
You know, it's funny, man, because when you stopped it, I was feeling the same thing at that time. I was like, you know what, man? They were just out of here. I bet you after they finished recording this shit, I bet you they're like, yeah, that's the one.
Mm-hmm.
That shit is out of here. Was that the number one on the streaming service that we're using?
Yes.
That's the number one song. Yeah, I feel it feels that way to me.
The number one song on the streaming service we use.
It feels like everybody is killing it.
Yes.
I love the drumming. I love the guitar work, the bassist too.
Crazy.
Her vocals. Dude, I feel like when this shit was done, they were like, this shit is out of here.
They just knew it.
This is out of here.
You know, it's a song where it's like, yeah,
when we put
this thing together, we were reacting way differently than a lot of other songs that we've done. Like, we love them all. They're all our children. We love them. But this one was special.
Yeah.
I don't know what happened in the studio, but
killing it.
This is hot. Great riffs, great drumming, great vocals.
Yeah.
We'll get into the lyrics, I guess, at this point, at some point, though. Let's get back to it. The guitar work is out. Yeah, the guitar work to me, I feel like the drumming is, I love the drumming too. I feel like the drumming is really getting right. But the guitar work in this is nasty though.
Mm-hmm.
God damn. Shout out to Ann and Nancy Wilson, man. The guitar work is so nasty.
They're killing it.
So nasty. Just the bass and everything going on. The bam, down, bam, 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 bam.
Yeah. They're killing it.
I don't know what else you need.
Destroyed it.
Yeah.
Destroyed it, dude. Destroyed it.
This is super playlist. I'm not bullshitting you at all. And it's not because we're thinking about doing a Women Who Rock marathon. Don't think there's no bias.
Yeah,
because
if I didn't like it and George didn't like it.
And we would have no problem.
That's what it is.
Yeah, let's finish this up.
You better make up something quick. You gonna
That sounds like that could have been
alone?
Hot too.
That sounds like ballady, Ryan. Yeah. I don't know, man.
No, I can do that. I can do that. And you gotta be hard all the time.
Let's put it to the test.
Yeah, but Barracuda was fire.
It does a little bit.
I wonder where you are tonight.
Dude, I don't care. I'm not bullshit.
And the night goes by so very slow.
She sounds great, though.
Oh, I hope that it won't end.
Just want to get to the chorus.
Yeah.
The chorus hit.
Save that for another reaction. Yeah, because that's hot. Dude, Heart is quickly going up the list here at Las Vegas.
Pat Benatar.
I didn't know who that was, but I definitely didn't know
if it
was.
I love that song.
That is a good song.
Na, na, na,
yeah.
Na, na. That shit is crazy.
Yeah.
I'm dead ass serious.
Yeah, so, but back to Barracuda, though, because we may have to get back to Alone there. But
we might just do back-to-back.
Yeah, because that shit is hot. But, dude, they rocked the hell out of that, dude. And I am, like I said, I'm no bullshit, guys. That Heart is very, very quickly going up the list here. Wait, because they're 3 for 3 right now. We didn't get through the third song. But, dude, Crazy on You was hot. I like that. That's on the playlist. Barracuda is going to get on the playlist. Yes. And that alone, that shit sound hot, too. You know what I'm saying? Because I've heard that song. So.
That to me is a classic. I know that wasn't so much, and I've heard that a lot.
Yeah, dude.
Damn. Barracuda was great, dude. That's like, there's not, every playlist make is not equal. They're not equal. You know what I'm saying? Some I've said this before. Some songs make playlists. They, you know, they stay on there for about a couple weeks. And then they're out of here. And some just remain. I know that this is going to remain on my playlist.
And why in the hell am I late to the game with Heart? Because they are dope. I mean, super is there dope. Anything that they can't do? They're playing the instruments, they're singing. I mean, it's groovy.
The writing. You got to get to the writing.
I mean.
We didn't really look at the lyrics, but yeah.
But dude, I mean, I've been sleeping on them. Seriously.
Vocals are great. I think the vocals are great.
Yeah.
They're creative with how they approach the tracks. Because I really do feel like that was really creative how she approached it with sort of like a, I don't know if it was a pop approach. I just think her voice sounds like something that you could hear a pop star sound, just her tone, but just that ba da da da.
Yeah.
And just sort of contrasting with these nasty.
It's just dope.
And I'm not into like.
And they're just super.
Sometimes, but the way they pulled that off.
And they're just super talented too.
Just the movement in the music, the bass work, drum work in this was just nasty.
Yeah.
Very, very dope. And it's catchy and it just bangs.
And this is for all the people that be like, oh, it's good for a female artist. They good for anybody. Dude, I put them up against any guy dominated band. I'll put that up against
easily.
All that. That shit's hot.
Air easily.
You cannot front on greatness, man. You
fire.
Just can't.
You cannot. In the lyrics, man, it just seems like they're talking about being backstabbed or some sort of, when they said you're lying so low into the weeds. And it said that the title of the song is Barracuda, but that to me sounds like a snake, right? You have to keep the grass cut low so you can see the snakes coming. But so it seems like it's symbolic of them, you know, snakes are sort of, they're slithering around them, right?
Yep.
I don't know if it has to do with a relationship or business. I don't know what's going on, but I'd like to kind of read into that a little bit more. We were so into the groove, man, that, but it seems like it was just deception of some sort.
I think so too, dude, because especially the way she sang it with so much passion and so much, you know, power in her voice, and you got me down, down, down on my knees, Barracuda. But I know a Barracuda is like a vicious fish, right? You know what I'm saying? That there's like a scavenger of the sea type of thing,
yeah.
But I think it's fitting if she's talking about being backstabbed, you know, and just basically a predator, you know what I'm saying? Preying on people that may be in a vulnerable state, and maybe she was wronged at some point in time.
Some point.
Or they were wronged at some point in their time in their career or something, and correlating that to a Barracuda. So
that's what it seems like.
You know.
Because it says, even in verse 2, now that we've had a little bit of time as you were speaking and I was listening, to look at the lyrics, it says, back over time, we were all trying for free. you met the porpoise in me. No right, no wrong. You're selling a song, a name, a whisper game. So it could be the porpoise could be representative of a green, impressionable heart. You know, we were trying for free. We were just carefree playing music, doing it for the love of it.
Yep.
And I'm looking at words like whisper game. And then up top, she says, smile like the sun kisses for everyone. So it's like smile on your face.
And then
whisper behind your back and backstab
all the time
you.
They
so
wanna take your place.
All of that shit.
Backstab.
Yes, sir. But yeah, great song, man. Playlist for both me and Ryan. Yeah, give us more heart. Matter of fact, you might not have to. We might just go straight with Alone.
Yeah.
We might go straight with Alone. So outside of Alone, because I think that's something that we want to get in, because that chorus is amazing.
Yeah, it is.
Give us some other suggestions for them, but they are fire. Why did we take so long to get back?
I don't know, man.
God damn.
I don't know. Sleeping on that.
Yep. That's the interview, guys. If you enjoyed it, please hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. And also, guys, check out our Patreon channel if you're interested. It will allow you to get exclusive access to our content. The link for that will be in the description. I'm George. That's Ryan. Lost in Vegas.
We out.
We out.